Doug, the Street Recreation Center. It's a real privilege to have you with us today. And the real reason that I was asked to come here today was to find out if they had a permit for your little parade. You're really hard up for money, okay? it is a real privilege to be here today. And as I was thinking about what I might say, thought came to me last night. And, I think about the Taylors. The mayor of Colchester's name is Taylor. And believe it or not, he and I get along really, really well. Okay? I would be at fault, not the Taylors, okay? But I was thinking about the value of a good name. And I came up with something that I thought was kind of interesting. The value of a good name. We receive our name at birth, then we spend our lives attaching meaning to it. We all know people who have built great value around their names. If you mention the name, people will remember something about that person's character. The opposite's also true. Now, there's a book called Proverbs in the Bible. Verse 1 says, "A good name is more desirable than great riches. To be esteemed is better than silver or gold." The reason that it's so important is that a person can have riches and have a name that nearly incites a riot. Think of Bernie Madoff, okay? Or think of a local politician, you know what I mean? But the writer of Ecclesiastes agrees that your name is valuable. A good name is better than fine perfume. It leaves a pleasant fragrance in the air when it is spoken. And I'm sure that's true of the Taylor name. And I know your history is quite wide and varied. Is my understanding from research that's been sent to me that you are descendants of Captain Matthew Taylor, who is buried in the Roby Street Cemetery, along with just about all the mayors of Truro and some of our founding members of this community of the town of Truro. So, you're up there, I guess. So that's a good thing. So, we're very pleased to have you with us today. And, our community, I understand you have connections with the Archibald family. The Archibald family, one of the founding members of this area. I live on Archibald Street. My backyard is, the former backyard of the first mayor of Truro. And it's kind of, he was the first, I'm the 20th, okay? Wow. And I don't know how many kids he had, but we had 7, so I think I got a beat on that. But nevertheless, it's very interesting. Archibald Street I live on, the top of the street is Adam Archibald. That was the first mayor. Over on Burnett is named after his wife, Lady Burnett. And so, the history is there. If you look at Cottage Street, that's where the road went up to his cottage, which was his home. And they bought over Dutch elm trees back in the, I think it was the 1700s, somewhere around there. And they were all planted as young saplings right down to the cottage lane. And so now when we moved in, these are majestic 150-year-plus trees, of which we lost about 3/4 of them to Hurricane Juan a few years back. I still remember looking out the window that night. My little boy, Dennis, at that time, said, "Dad," he said, "that elm tree down at Mr. Roberts' house, it's almost bent over so far you can't see it." And I said, "Well, it's not bent over, it's gone." Mm-hmm. And so we lost a lot of history, but, the Archibalds, the Taylors, and a whole lot of other names certainly have added to our area, and certainly, we're very pleased about the Truro and what it represents. It means many things to many people, and we hope when you leave here that will mean something really good. So on that note, thank you for coming. I hope you have a really good weekend, and believe me, it was an honor to be here. Thank you.